Hip-hop has been the market leader at the front line of innovation for the entire industry in East Africa, whether it was groups like Kalama Shaka and K-South in Kenya, Professor Jay and Mwana FA from Tanzania, to Clear Cut in Uganda. Rappers have helped push the industry forward with dynamic recordings, cutting-edge videos and content that was hard-hitting and enjoyable. In no place was this more apparent in the early years than with the efforts of the Ugandan rap scene. Names like MC Afreek and D&D Slam have become the stuff of myth, let alone legend. The efforts of groups like Prim and Proper made sure that hip-hop in Uganda is what would lead the way continentally. They were doing rap before it became the norm.
So talking about a crew that I'm proud to, you know, offer this Lifetime Achievement Award to, the crew and the award goes to none other than Prim and Proper, you know, Lillian Butare and Brenda Zobo, who truly took it upon themselves to inspire women in hip-hop and R&B.
Before it was accepted and before it was allowed on radio, this purposeful siding of the industry did the exact opposite of disheartening hip-hop. It made hip-hop fight harder, longer, and more ferocious in its appeal. A new wave began in the early 2000s with Da Squad, Sylvester and Abrams, Clear Cut, Urban Life, Bataka Underground, and Chain Thought Reaction that set up their own platforms to expose their music to the public. Their movements in DV8 and Cinefreak helped to show that they were in the caliber of any genre in Africa at the time. Becoming solo acts, stars began to step out of the groups that had molded them. During this time, Lyrical G, The Myth, Crooked, now known as Ruyonga, Baba and Rocky Giant were able to move as a unit and yet retain their solo appeal, and this brought strength to the genre. 2009 saw our first outing of quality stages and costume changes that mirrored the Half the Legend debut Navio concert. Again, Uganda borrowed from hip-hop to change the way concerts happen today. By 2010, the biggest surge for hip-hop saw Navio and GNL have back-to-back concerts with over 10,000 people in attendance. This was not just a first for the genre, but a first for Uganda. Rap-inspired fusions by Benon with Mr. DJ. And Just Jose's whistle song and UG Swag. Ushered in a new level for rap, where Yuga Flow and Luga Flow could never be left off a hit collaborative song. Female acts began to pop up to rival the boys, as Yala, Slyke, and Milka had in the DV8 days. Artists like Saint CA and Keko, who went on to win the most coveted of awards at Channel O, showed that the women were able to break boundaries that even the men couldn't. The new wave, who have emerged like Flex the Paper and Big Trill, have enjoyed some international play on the bigger networks as the Fick for Makers, The Agents, Price Tabers, Fefe Busis, Codes and Tuckers of this world are finding new ways to push the art form. With Trill's Patte After Patte becoming the biggest party anthem in Africa and the diaspora alike. It's the hip-hop fans and the media who have allowed for hip-hop to keep breaking boundaries as they do. So we at Eno Hip Hop thank these media brave enough to push the most internationally recognized genre to come out of Uganda. Eno Lifestyle. Eno groundbreaking, Eno revolutionary, Eno hip hop.